this weekend, and this game will determine who moves on to play for the championship belt. So we're going to quickly run through some charter rosters here. I am Mamacita, and with me is
Rock the Mike.
Yes, so we have, I'll go through Paradise City here. Paradise City 1-0, Nora Specht. 1-0-1-0, Elsie Hammer. 1-1-1, Ratlin Bones. 1-7, Judgment Day. 2-2, Brutally Blonde. 24, Bammer. 27, Bombs Away. 305, Blackie Chan. 4, Go Go Bananas. 44, Bang Bang. 5, Pocahontas. 58, Assassin Bites. 74, ETs. 78, Amazona Getcha. 8, Brat. 88, Hula Tula. 89, Alice Affliction. And 92, Guns N' Roses.
And skating for Omaha in the green, we have 0602, Rylan Gottesling. 101, Sharon Misery. 1941 is Jenny Cash. 212, Chaos Murphy. 22 is Penelope Brews. 3, Holmes Sweet Holmes. 30 is Skateaway Faye. 32, Amelia Earhart. 369 is Soul Crusher. 38, Crash Heartless. 4272, Toxic Tina. Number 6, Danielle Yakoffin. 616 is Meg Skeeto. 626, Hip E Check. 69, Bobby Backseat. 750, Southern Discomfort. 777, Ready Ruck. 80 is Molly Masker. And 964 is E-Blastigirl.
All right, so we're going to get right to the action here. You'll see there number 44, which is Bang Bang, already through for lead jam. Now this is her first scoring pass here. A grand slam as the Omaha Jammer is still stuck in the pack. And here she comes back through for another scoring pass, being forced to the outside there by number 626 of Omaha.
And that is E-Blastigirl jamming for Omaha.
And there we go, Bang Bang through for another 5 points. And calls off the jam. So first jam of the game, seeing Paradise City putting up 10 points, Omaha with 0.
And just over a minute away, so fairly quick jam here.
Mm-hmm.
We haven't seen a whole lot of jams going overly long this weekend, but we have seen a few that actually did go the full 2 minutes, even with a lead jammer being declared. So that was kind of interesting to see.
All right, now we'll remind you folks that have been watching all weekend that we cannot see the jammers until they're well into turns 1 and 2, so please forgive us if we're a little delayed on calling out who they are. I do know that that is Elsie Hammer jamming for Paradise City. She's through for lead jam. Jamming for Omaha is
Rady Ruck.
There we go, Rady Ruck. Rady Ruck struggling to get past those last three defenders. She does so on her initial. Meanwhile, Elsie through for 4 points. Waiting a little bit there until her coach tells her call off the jam, and she does. So 4 more points up on the board for Paradise City.
Yeah, Rady Ruck about a quarter lap behind the pack when that call-off happens. So not enough time for Elsie Hammer to get back around and try and get anything else.
No, and Elsie Hammer does a really good job of watching her bench, and her coach is very, very good with time management. So I think that's going to be something that's very helpful to Paradise City here. Again, both of these teams undefeated, so this game very, very important. Whoever wins this, going on to play for the championship belt.
And it is, in fact, a championship
it
belt.
It is so beautiful.
Alice Affliction jamming for Paradise City. Omaha's jammer trapped behind a four wall of Paradise defense, trying to work her way through.
And there we go. Amelia Earhart is number 32. That's the Omaha jammer. But Paradise City is through for lead. Amelia Earhart now through on her initial pass.
About a half a lap behind.
Mm-hmm. I have a feeling that those leads are going to be very, very important in this game. It seems that that's Paradise City's strategy here is get lead, get through, call it off. They're not messing around here, I think, until they get a comfortable lead, and with a team like Omaha that's gone undefeated all weekend just as they have, I don't know that there will ever be a comfortable lead.
Yeah, so how do you define a comfortable lead? So you're not going to be able to get 100, 150 points on a team like this.
I don't think so. And both of these teams have put up point spreads like that against other teams all weekend. So, and they've been watching each other. It's no secret that, that you know, the top four teams are definitely the top four teams for a reason.
Ryan Saint, with 26 minutes remaining, Paradise City on top 17-0. Omaha yet to score, but we're only on jam four. And now that I've said it, they should come through and put some points on the board because that's how these things always work.
Of course. There we go. We've got number five. That is Pocahontas jamming for Paradise City. She's through for lead jam. We've got
Skate Away Faye.
Taking a little whip off of her her teammate's jersey to get through on her initial pass.
Hard to see the numbers when they keep shifting side to side so fast.
Yeah, dodgy little jammers. So 1 point there for Paradise, 0 for Omaha. So Paradise with 18 points, 25 minutes to go in the first half of the game.
Yeah, Paradise City clearly in control to start off this game. Mm-hmm. No idea how long that's going to last.
That's the thing is, Omaha isn't really a pushover team, so Paradise City is going to have to be very, very careful and make sure that it's not going to their heads at any point that they're winning.
Yes, and of our top four teams, three of them are undefeated. The fourth team, only one loss underneath them, so it's going to be a hard-fought climb to the top for whoever wins this game and the game going on the other track right now.
All right, so that is Bang Bang working her way past that last blocker, three for lead jam. So far, lead percentage 100% going to Paradise City, and it's showing on the scoreboard.
Yeah, Rady Ruck jamming for Omaha, hoping that Ruck will be a Rady as she tries to get through.
Ouch, so that was Bang Bang taking a little spill there, getting knocked over by one of the Omaha blockers, and looks like she's struggling to get through a little bit. Being recycled now by number 0602, Ryan Gottesling.
This could just be the break that Omaha needs to get their jammer through, get some points on that board.
Yep, and there we go. Once again, Bang Bang being taken all the way back, but also the
Rady Ruck having to drop back just as far. And she was actually further ahead, too.
Mm-hmm. It's got to be demoralizing. I'm not a jammer myself, so I can't imagine how horrible that must feel. But I mean, these jammers get the snot beat out of them for most of the game and still keep going. So they're definitely the heroes in my book. All right, so LC Hammer back on the line. That's number 1010 for Paradise. And we'll let you know in just a second who that is for Omaha.
I'm banking on Amelia Earhart.
Yeah, looks like. And LC through four.
It is Amelia Earhart. Okay, so we do have rotation set up.
All right, LC approaching the back of the pack. Only two blockers from Omaha out on the track. She gets through, picks up 3 points, calls off that jam.
So that's six jams now in a row. Paradise City lead jammer, only points on the board. 25-0 currently the score with 22.5 remaining.
Yeah, very good start for Paradise City, but again, still lots of time left on the clock. Omaha at some point might want to call a timeout.
kind of adjust, reset. Do some evaluating. Hey, we need to do something different here.
Right, yeah.
Not sure what that needs to be. Just going to make a change. Mm-hmm. Something small.
All right, so we have, can't quite see. There we go, number 89 jamming for Paradise City. That is Alice Affliction. And
you blast
a girl. Omaha again with the penalties. Oh, but of course, just as I say that, the jammer for Paradise City coming in really hot, knocking a blocker over with a forearm, so she's going to sit in the penalty box. And here is Omaha's opportunity to put up some more points. They're finally
here
on the board there with five. And
only 20 points to make up for a tie game. You and I have seen a ridiculously large number of ties.
Absolutely. This weekend's been crazy. So many back and forth games, so many comebacks from pretty, you know, large deficits, 30, 40, 50 points. And yeah, it's been a great weekend. Very, very closely matched teams. And these two teams, in fact, are ranked fairly close together. Paradise City sitting at 72 in the WFTDA, Omaha sitting at 69. So, you know, it doesn't get much closer than that.
So in Paradise City, doing one of the things that they do incredibly well, that's strong, solid walls.
Yeah. So must be an Aussie thing.
Yeah, they completely killed that entire penalty time there.
Mm-hmm. And again, taking down Elastigirl. Meanwhile, their jammer, Alice Affliction, is back in play. So back on the track, already scoring points. Put up 4 in that last pass. And still about 11 seconds to go in this jam. Another 4 points on the board for Paradise City.
And Elastigirl trying to get through this 2-all, ran almost into the infield in turn 4.
Two more points up on the board for Paradise, and 5 points on the board there for Omaha.
There we go. Okay, 4 more coming in after that.
Yeah, 4 more after. I thought that
yeah,
didn't look
quite
right.
See, yeah.
There we go. So Omaha up to 9 points. Paradise City, though, up to 35. 19 and a half minutes to go in the first half.
Paradise City lining up in the front of the pack. They're in the grayish blue and white. Omaha in the back in green.
Mm-hmm.
Bolt jammers. Nice. Fighting through. Rady Ruck jamming for Omaha.
Yeah, and Omaha definitely with the pack advantage here, but that tripod of blockers for Paradise City forcing a penalty there on the Omaha jammer. It was a back block, so she'll sit in the penalty box. We now have a power jam for Paradise City, and that is number 5, Pocahontas, that is jamming for them.
And there we go. She has been called lead.
And she is going to call off that jam. I think she was just struggling with that specific group of blockers. Sometimes it's better to just, you know when you're not doing well, call it off, put fresh legs out there to hopefully be able to do something with the power jam and put up some points.
And 0-0 jam, and this is the first jam in this half the Paradise City has not scored.
Yeah, wow. All right, so about 18 and a half minutes to go. Paradise City moving things up to the pivot line. On a power start here.
Ooh, almost had a false start warning there. Oh, Omaha's pivot putting her toe on the line.
There we go. That is LC Hammer through for lead jam on this power start. And LC Hammer being forced to the inside there by one of the Omaha blockers. Not recycling too far back. And now dealing with that 3-wall. LC Hammer keeping her arms in. I don't know if you can really see that on the screen, but she's making a very conscious effort to keep her arms pinned to her chest so that she's not taking those forearm penalties. I've only called one of their games so far, so I don't know if that's been an issue for her in some of the other games. But
not that I remember seeing.
Yeah.
But it could be because she does that, it hasn't been an issue.
Yeah, possibly.
What is an issue is Rady Ruck going back into the penalty box for a cutting the track penalty.
Yes. So, so far, penalties definitely playing a factor in the score. In terms of skating ability and everything else, the teams seem fairly evenly matched, but Omaha definitely with more jammer penalties and blocker penalties, so that could become a very big factor.
Yeah, as far as jammer penalties go, it's 2-1 right now.
Mm-hmm.
So Omaha with the 2, a back block and a cutting the track. In Paradise, it was just a single forearm.
Right. And there we go, bang, bang, out for lead jam.
And Rady Ruck standing now in the penalty box, coming out any second now.
Number 22, they're Brutally Blonde, taking out one of the blockers. Very effective, actually, because that was allowed her jammer to get through. That blocker was being a pain for her jammer. There we go. Omaha jammer through. That is Rady Ruck. That was her initial, though. So Paradise City putting up one more point, calling that off. And, yeah, score not changing a whole lot there. 7 points total in that jam for Paradise City. So 47-9, 16 minutes to go in the first half.
Yeah, so right about the halfway mark here for this first period.
Mm-hmm.
Paradise City very firmly in control. Lead jammer every jam so far. And we are, that was 10 jams in. This is number 11 starting right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, as a coach, if you know my team was playing against Paradise right now, I might be calling a timeout just to chat about what we can do differently to get those lead jams, because that seems to be what is allowing Paradise to have control of the game right now.
Yeah, so now Suffliction getting through lead jammer, but she picks up a forearm.
Yes, she does. So
this is the second time she's done that, actually.
There we go. We've got
Hippie Chick. Number 626 for Omaha.
Hippie Chick out. Was that? Oh, no, that was her initial pass. I'm sorry. I thought that was potentially a scoring pass, but she's coming in now on her scoring pass.
And hit a very strong Paradise City three wall.
Yeah, very strong.
Omaha with the 4-2 pack advantage as Alice Affliction rejoins play.
Oh, and there goes the Paradise City jammer. Shoots out of the penalty box right through the pack with really no opposition at all. But Hippie Chick putting up points. So 4 points on the board for Hippie Chick. Oh, big hit there. I can't quite see that skater's number. There we go, number 0.38. So 38, Crash Heartless with a huge, huge hit. And
also forcing the cutting the track penalty.
Yeah.
But wow. Hippie Chick getting a cutting the track penalty also.
Hashtag all the jammer penalties.
Yes. 3 jammer penalties so far in one jam.
Wow. So Alice Affliction out already. Hippie Chick also out. Both jammers are on a scoring pass. This is a crazy jam. There's a lot
really
of hitting,
is.
A lot of contact, almost unnecessary contact happening between the blockers. But again, this is an important game, right? I mean, they're playing for all the gravy. So both teams want this bad. They're both undefeated. No one wants to go home after winning 4 games, you know, with a loss. They want to keep winning. All right, so 52 for Paradise City, 17 for Omaha, 13 minutes left to go in this first half.
Timeout has been called by Paradise City. They guys have some time to run some numbers.
Absolutely.
Because we do those kinds of things here because
I love me my numbers.
We're giant derby nerds.
So currently, let's see here. So Paradise City needs about 44% of the points in this game to maintain their current rank, which is 72. Omaha, being the higher ranked team at 69, needs about 49% of the points. So right now, Omaha, well below that, they're at about 25% of the points. So, of course, that means Paradise City is sitting at about 75% of the points. When it's such a low-scoring game, those percentages can change very quickly mm-hmm. with any points going up on the board. So as we go along in the game, I'll try and keep you updated on where we're at for the fans at home from either of these teams so they can kind of keep track.
Being that they're ranked so closely together, too, mm-hmm. weights shouldn't come into too much of a play with that either.
Not too much, no.
So there might be a little bit of play with it, maybe a place or two.
Absolutely. And with all of the games that these teams have played this weekend, things are going to shift a little bit anyways. But just to give you a general idea right now, Paradise City winning both in terms of percentage there and also on the scoreboard. All right.
Amelia Earhart out in front, breaking the streak.
That is their first lead all game. So, 17 minutes in and their first lead jam for Omaha. And very, very well timed as number 5, Pocahontas, the jammer for Paradise City, now going to the penalty box. So
very lucky break here for Amelia Earhart, lead jammer. And a power jam situation.
Mm-hmm.
But they have to get past those Paradise City walls, which have been unyielding all weekend long.
They have been, and such great penalty kills. I don't know. I wouldn't just sit back if I was the Omaha blockers at this point.
Yeah, then you get up there, do some, you know, behind, some shifting here. Yeah. There we go. Move ahead. Try and break open a lane.
It's almost like they heard us, but they didn't.
Nope. We are not that loud. You guys can hear us just fine, but they can't hear us at all. Star pass going to the pivot for Omaha.
So 2 points up there for Omaha.
That is Ryan Gottesling taking the star.
And Paradise City Jammer is out of the box, still on her initial pass, so it is okay that she has the star cover in her hand.
But we are going to go the full 2 minutes now.
There we go. Paradise City through on their initial pass. We've got the Jammer for Omaha working hard, but Paradise City, again, that defense is just unbelievable. They force her to the infield, number 92, Guns N' Roses, making her really work there at the back of the pack.
Omaha doing some fantastic blocking here, though, coming around turn four, putting Pocahontas outside, mm-hmm. and then dragging her all the way back to the beginning of turn three.
Yeah, this is a rough jam. Crazy defense.
Paradise City three wall up in the front. And time expires. Bolt Jammer's picking up an additional 4 points.
There we go. So after that jam, I mean, Omaha netting 2 points in that. That was a lot of work for 2 points, though. That jammer's got to be exhausted. So 6 for Omaha on that one, 4 for Paradise City. Score sitting at 23 for Omaha, 56 Paradise City. So again, I mentioned the percentages. Just those few points actually affect it quite a bit because it's such a low-scoring game.
Elsie Hammer on the line for Paradise City, trying to find a way through.
Oh, but Elastigirl.
Oh, sneaky, sneaky.
She just managed to find that space on the inside, and she doesn't need much room. So. And Elastigirl just coming in super hot into the backs there. But she does come in cleanly, like right along the shoulders. And still not getting through, still struggling with those now a tripod of Aussie blockers. But Elsie Hammer also struggling, being pulled all the way back.
Now the Blaster Girl does get through, picks up five.
And LC finally through on her initial.
So Blaster Girl seeing her coming through, trying to call it off. There it is.
Yeah, that was number four that took her to the outside. That's Go Go Bananas. I've seen her play a very effective derby all weekend. I got to call Paradise City in their game this morning, and she was one of the standout blockers mm-hmm. for me, for sure.
Yeah, I got to see them twice yesterday.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely making an impression.
And Omaha holding Paradise City scoreless for only the second jam of this game.
Mm-hmm. But the score is tightening up now. It's only 26 points separating the two teams.
And Bang Bang able to get around Molly Masker, so she's going to be your lead jammer. Paradise City reclaiming.
And it looks like the Omaha jammer heading to the penalty box.
Yeah, Rady Rock.
Oh, I believe it was for hitting a down skater, if I'm not mistaken.
So that's her third penalty as a jammer.
Yeah, those add up quick. I mean, we're still only in the first half, still, you know, just under 9 minutes to go. So she's got to be careful there.
That's right. So this is day three of a long, hard tournament.
Oh, yeah.
Fourth game for both of these teams, mm-hmm. and the winner goes on to play one more.
Yeah.
So you definitely want to play smart here. Don't work yourself too hard. Don't get worn out.
Yeah, and that's why earlier I was saying, you know, it almost seems like there's some unnecessary contact happening with the blockers. I mean, whoever wins this does go on. They're going to need to conserve a little bit of that energy. But that could also just be inexperience, I guess, in terms of tournament play.
Right. So this is when you really need to dig deep and just play smart.
Yes. Yeah.
So in either case, whether you know you're done or you go on, yeah, it's, you need to conserve some energy. You need to make better moves. Because if you are going on after this, you're going to have the hardest game of the weekend coming up.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. So Paradise City putting up 3 more points there on that jam. That was a big jam for Paradise City, though. 18 points for Bang Bang on that one. So I think that's potentially the highest scoring jam so far of the game.
It is indeed.
Yes.
So the next highest from that was only 10.
Mm-hmm. So same thing happened this morning. Bang Bang was just unstoppable. All right, so.
Omaha lined up in the front in green. Paradise City in blue and white in the back.
Oh, and I believe that's five. Jammer, Polka Hot Ass, taking another penalty. So another jammer that's kind of going to have to watch, as I believe she's also been in three times?
Twice, looking maybe. At it. I don't see anything for her as a jammer.
Oh, okay. My mistake. Oh, nice work there by number 27. Bombs away. Really working Amelia Earhart. Amelia Earhart does find a little bit of space on the outside there. Takes it. Is super lead jam. But Pocahontas already out from her penalty through on her initial pass. Made that look easy, actually.
So Amelia Earhart needs to get through here. Call it off. There we go.
There we go.
Get that one.
Yes, 1 point. Her team seems very happy about that 1 point. And, I mean, when you're fighting tooth and nail for every point, it's definitely something to be happy about. So 74, Paradise City, 31, Omaha, 6 minutes to go in this first half.
And Brat, the pivot for Paradise City, toe on the line. There we go. Omaha matching with Soul Crusher.
All right, so Elsie Hammer jamming for Paradise. And I believe that's a Blaster Girl.
Is it a Blaster Girl? It's
maybe
or
not.
Is it Skateaway Faye?
Skateaway Faye. Good eye.
But Elsie Hammer already through. Lee Jammer coming up in a scoring position as she enters the frame.
And again, Elsie Hammer coming in with her arms up against her chest. They're trying to avoid forearm penalties, so.
Skate away face, skating away as she comes around.
Falls off the fan.
Almost getting caught up to Elsie Hammer, but 3 points for Paradise City at the call-off.
So 31-77 in favor of Paradise. 5 minutes to go in the first half of the game.
Yeah, starting to run out of time here. Omaha definitely making some good adjustments. Seem to keep going with that and take it a few steps further.
Yeah, they're definitely going to have to chat at the half, though, because they've got to figure out something to counter that crazy defense, whether that be, you know, sending one player up for offense. Whatever they decide to do, they need to, you know, action that in the second half. Otherwise, it could potentially be a game where it's, you know, really, really dominated by one team. So.
And that is Bang Bang getting lead jammer for Paradise City.
Oh,
Omaha's blockers are trying to open some holes, but their jammer's still trapped on the outside here, coming across the pivot line.
Yeah, and Bang Bang taking advantage of the fact that her blockers were a little distracted and just kind of skirted right through there, no problems.
And that is the Blaster Girl jamming this time out for Omaha, trying to get around this three wall at the front. But Bang Bang recycled back.
Yeah, really nice bridge there by the Omaha players, making sure that none of their players were, you know, going back too far. But Bang Bang really, really paying attention. Sees just the tiniest little bit of room on the inside. Goes through. She's due for 5 points for Paradise City.
And already lining back up, coming around for another scoring pass. Clears the pack steadily. Good for five more.
Mm-hmm.
And a star pass on the Omaha side.
And that is a pass to Hippie Chick. Oh, nice little attempt at an apex jump there. Don't think she picked up any points on that, but nonetheless, it looked really cool. And one more point up on the board there for Paradise. So a 16-point jam there for Paradise City. So got a couple big ones up there now, a 19 point, a 16 point. So those start to add up, and it's clearly reflected here. It looks like they're taking some points away. Oh, okay, they dropped it down to 11 points on that. Not really sure how that works.
Had an extra pass, and that got counted.
Potentially, yeah. So 88, Paradise City, 31, Omaha. 2.5 minutes in the first half of the game. We've got number five jamming for Paradise City. That is Polka Hot Ass and
Rady Ruck on the back there. Rady Ruck, one of the taller jammers for Omaha, making it a little easier to spot her coming around. We take anything we can.
And Polka Hot Ass for a lead jam for Paradise City. Rady Ruck about a half track behind her. And we've got a couple blocker penalties there for Paradise City. So it could work towards Omaha's advantage if they do this properly and effectively. I mean, they've got a full pack out right now. So, you know, four against two, the numbers kind of speak for themselves. But, you know, in the earlier game that Paradise City had, I saw them same kind of penalty troubles and still super effective with only two blockers. So.
Yeah, so we've seen blockers out there that by themselves can hold back incredibly powerful jammers. So we'll have to see how this goes down with Amelia Earhart trying to get some more points on the board for Omaha.
And, Amelia Earhart did manage to get lead jam there after almost 20 seconds. That was a lot of work. But she is lead. She's coming through on a scoring pass. That one was easy. Just right along the outside there. Then calling off the jam, leaving Elsie Hammer with 0 points. So 35 Omaha, 89 Paradise City.
So we're running down less than a minute left on the clock here. 45 seconds, all that remaining in this first half.
That went by very, very, very quickly.
Yes, it did. So we're only, this is going to be jam number 20 we're about to start.
And not an excessive amount of, you know, timeouts or official reviews or anything like
that. No, only one timeout being called.
Yeah. All right. So bang, bang, jamming for Paradise City. There we go. Bang, bang, two for lead jam. Meanwhile, the Omaha jammer, and that is
Skateaway Faye.
Skateaway Faye. Still stuck behind those three blockers. Oh.
Ooh. That was close. Luckily for her, she was still straddling.
Yeah, definitely. Close call on that one.
She had half an inch when that foot came in.
So Skateaway Faye choosing to block a little bit here, and doesn't work out so well for her. She's still stuck behind those same three blockers. Meanwhile, Bang Bang picking up five more points for Paradise City. And there we go. Skateaway Faye finally through on her initial pass.
Bang Bang trying to work her way through.
Oh, and Bang Bang actually being called on a high block. So that worked out okay. We've got about still 50 seconds or so left on this jam, and Skateaway Faye on the power jam for Omaha.
Five points picked up already. Five more on this pass.
Yeah, nice footwork there. She manages to just spin around that front blocker and keep on going. So five power points up on the board. We'll see if she can get any more on there before Bang Bang comes out.
And Omaha holding the pack steady for her right in the center of your screen as she was coming around.
Skateaway Faye forced back by Bratt.
And have dropping way back.
Yeah, absolutely. Number 92, Guns N' Roses. Really
close
really
to
moved.
50 feet.
Yeah, and but she still went back, so clearly that worked. Go. That is the end of the first half. So very, very quick first half there. Again, not a lot of delays. We've got Omaha sitting at 49, Paradise City at 100. Sorry, 99, not quite 100. So yeah, that is the first half of the game. What do you think, Mike?
I think Paradise has been very firmly in control for most of it, but they're starting to get a little sloppy towards the end of this half.
Jammer penalties in particular, I think they're going to have to watch that. And
that's something that Omaha has to worry about as well. And say jammer penalties have been pretty influential in this first half in terms of who's been able to take advantage of what.
Mm-hmm. I would couldn't agree more. In terms of numbers, I mean, they kind of speak for themselves. It's pretty easy to figure out the percentages on this, but yeah, Omaha really, really needing to pick it up. Going to have to chat for sure about what they can do, because it's those lead jams. When the Jammers have lead, they're in control, and you know, 95% of the time, it's been Paradise City getting through for lead jams.
Right.
So Omaha needing to do something to change it up here. So we'll see how they come out in the second half. But again, the winner of this game moving on to play for the championship belt, the loser being eliminated from the tournament. Yeah, everything is at stake here.
Yeah, so we'll see if we can't get a little bit more information during the half. And we'll come back and talk to you guys in just about 6 minutes.
Yes, absolutely. I'm Mamacita.
I'm Rock the Mic.
And we will see you soon.
right, everybody, welcome back. We're getting ready for the second half of the Omaha Roller Girls taking on the Paradise City Roller Derby. Mm-hmm. Coming out of the half, Paradise City on top, 99-49.
Yep.
So Paradise City clearly in control of the first half, and the numbers don't lie. Lead jammer status 80% of the time.
Yeah.
And even with that, a couple of those that they didn't have it were because of jammer penalties.
Yes.
So penalties playing a big impact here in the first half as far as lead jammer statuses go.
Yes, and if you're just tuning in, Paradise City in the blue and white, Omaha in the green and white. So that's that. Also, for those nerds out there that like to know the rankings, Paradise City is the lower ranked team, ranked number 72. Omaha ranked 69 currently in the WFTDA. So here we go. That is Bang Bang jamming for Paradise City, working up against those blockers in green, getting through for lead jam and
Rady Ruck, yeah.
Rady Ruck. I had to think about that for a second. Yeah, Rady Ruck on her initial pass. Bang Bang coming in almost a little cautiously. I haven't really seen her do that yet. Normally she comes in super hot, but coming in maybe trying to avoid penalties because she has been to the box
a few times.
So 2 points on that one for Paradise City, 49 for Omaha, 101 Paradise City.
Yeah, and another thing to take into account too, the winner of this game goes on to our championship game for the belt.
Yeah, and maybe they chatted about that at halftime about their jammers maybe
Let's
taking
Let's back it off a little bit, be a little more conservative. We've got the lead. Let's keep it where it's at. Try and spread it, but slowly.
Yep. Okay. So, Elsie Hammer jamming for Paradise City and heading to the penalty bus. Actually, that's not Elsie Hammer. My apologies. That's Alice Affliction taking a forearm penalty. So Omaha on a power jam.
And with lead as well.
Yeah, so Amelia Earhart.
Great opportunity here for them if they can capitalize on it.
Yeah, but her blocker is just kind of sitting back.
There you go. There's one there. Open up a lane.
And she tried to come in just a little too quickly. Came in front of the blocker and will now go and sit for a track cut penalty. Meanwhile, the Paradise City jammer, Alice Affliction, back on the track. So this will go for the full 2 minutes.
Yeah, and Alice Affliction was already coming out.
Apex jump there. Alice Affliction made it look easy. Just hopped right over that corner, picked up, no points on that. My apologies.
Since that was her initial, but still looked great doing it.
Now
there we
putting
go.
Up points. 5 points on that for Alice Affliction, bringing Paradise City up to 106.
Penalty box starting to clear out. Amelia Earhart coming back onto the track, so Omaha with a chance to score now.
Yeah, and both jammers on the scoring path there. Amelia Earhart redeeming herself after that penalty, putting up 4 points for Omaha. And Alice Affliction having a little more trouble on this pass here. No pack being assessed, and she's able to get through. So 5 more points on the board for Paradise City. Oh, but now another track cut penalty for Amelia Earhart.
Like we were talking about just a couple minutes ago, jammer penalties being costly in terms of this game. And this is a situation where you really need that lead jammer status. You need to be able to control the game.
Yeah. So
can't do that from the box.
No, you can't. And I think at this point, I mean, this is the fifth game for each of these teams this weekend. So it could have something to do with that. Usually when you have a 20-person charter, the jammers 95% of the time are going to be rostered for every game, right? So for all of the jammers, this is their fifth game this weekend. You know, that's a lot of games. It's a lot of skating, a lot of jumping, a lot of getting hit. Jammers really take a beating. So that could be contributing to, you know, normally a jammer might be a little bit more cautious and not jump the gun and come right back in. But when you're tired and, you know, thinking about 100 things at once, maybe you're just not paying as close attention as usual.
And a quick score correction here on that last pass. Omaha's jammer did get 5 on her first pass, and then 2 in the second. So Omaha now at 56 instead of 55.
That is helpful.
So a 60-point spread with 26 and a half minutes remaining in the game.
We've got Elsie Hammer on the power start. She is doing that. It looks really awkward keeping her elbows in like that, but it's working. I mean, she's not
avoiding those elbows and forearm penalties.
Exactly. So again, I'm not sure if that was something that she was struggling with in earlier games, but it's working for her this game. She's playing a fairly clean game. I think she's only had maybe one penalty so far. It doesn't really affect her agility, clearly. She's still able to you know, use her toe stops on that inside line.
Yeah, now that I'm paying a little more attention to it, I do remember seeing her do that yesterday as
well. Okay. Yeah, and she grabs onto the top of her shirt there and comes in like that. So it could be maybe an issue that she deals with at home as well. So just getting...
Yeah, good way to remind herself, keep the elbows tucked in.
Absolutely. I always do the armpits. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I always tell my players to do that too. Whenever, you know, if you're getting a lot of forearm penalties, just remember, armpits.
And you know, training throws, you put paper plates in there and you have to hold them in place.
Yeah.
Little things like that to get you used to keeping those elbows in.
Yep.
Right. Paradise City taking the time out.
Yeah. So 123 Paradise City, 56 for Omaha. Winner of this game will go on to play for the championship game a little bit later today. Supposed to start at 6 p.m. Not quite sure that that's going to happen.
I think we're running about a half an hour or so behind. Yeah. So probably closer to 6:30 would be the start time for that.
And they'll go on to play whoever the winner is between the two teams playing currently on the other track, which should be Oklahoma and Leeds. So maybe I'll try and get an update in a minute here and see where that is at. But right now looking like Paradise City in control here and potentially going to be the team that goes on to play again later today for the championship. I'm just going to quickly run some numbers here. So 123... for Paradise City, that puts them at, whoa, my calculator failed me there.
Like, that's not a number.
No, so it's about 69% of the points right now. So they're doing very, very well. Omaha falling a little bit below what's expected of them. But, you know, still 25 minutes left in this half.
And so plenty of time. A Blaster Girl on the line for Omaha, trying to get around a three wall right here at the front of the pack.
Those Paradise City blockers, they just have this way of, they get you into their hips, their side, and then they stop. So, but in a way that is not affecting, it's hard to explain, but not getting, where they're not getting the stop block, right? Mm-hmm. They're still taking those little steps. So very, very effective way of blocking and forcing a forearm penalty there on the Omaha jammer. So this is a power jam. It is called off. So 4 points on that for Paradise City. And the next jam will start with a power start for Paradise City. 44, bang, bang, a very, very good choice to put out when you don't have an opposing jammer to deal with.
Yes, a Blaster Girl going to the penalty box for a forearm. And then as that jam was about to be called off, a low block was issued right before the jam ended. I wasn't sure if it was the jammer getting that low block penalty or not, so it was interesting to see how that actually affected the call off.
Yeah.
But it was assessed to the pivot,
right,
not the jammer. So we're so continuing on.
Yeah. Bang, bang. Still not through. The opposing jammer now coming out, and that is a Blaster Girl coming out of the penalty box. Lead jam finally going there to Bang Bang. And oh my goodness, it looks like they're dancing at the front of the pack there. That is the backward skating blocker there, number 78, Amazon Agecha. And the Omaha jammer, I mean, Omaha jammer would deke to the right, deke to the left, and the blocker would follow her on her toe stop. So looked like they were dancing.
Yeah, Amazon will get you. Also taking some time jamming yesterday. She's been very effective in multiple different positions.
Mm-hmm.
Paradise City now up in the front, currently down one blocker, so 4-3 pack advantage for Omaha.
Yep.
Elsie Hammer jamming for Paradise City. Rady Ruck jamming for Omaha.
And, Omaha losing a blocker due to a forearm.
Rady Ruck with a very sticky two ball she's trying to get off of.
Yeah, and Elsie Hammer being recycled, allowing Rady Ruck to get through four lead jam. Oh, Rady Ruck coming right into the back of that Omaha blocker. And yep, that's going to send her to the penalty box. It was a forearm.
So power jam opportunity now for Omaha.
Mm-hmm.
As Rady Ruck gets through and picking up five.
All right, now there is a full contingent of blockers out there for Paradise City. Only three out there.
Omaha's blockers coming up.
Still
dropping back, though, not really doing much to help Rady Ruck out here.
You know, they might want to start doing something about that. The power
jam
kill.
She's got no offense here, so everything she's doing is on her own.
And Paradise City has a formidable power play defense.
Yeah.
I've seen it in every game I've watched of theirs so far, so you can't just sit back and do nothing. You have to get in there, especially when you're behind by, you know, well over, 60 points right now.
Yeah. So five more for Rady Ruck, and she calls off the jam with Elsie Hammer coming into scoring position.
Mm-hmm.
So good call there.
Yeah, so 66 for Omaha, 129 Paradise City, 21 minutes left to go in the game. You can't count Omaha out at this point.
Oh, no, still a lot of time left on the clock.
They are undefeated as well up until now, so they might be able to figure out what's going on here and turn this around. 20 minutes is still a ton of time to do that. So.
Yes, a 63-point spread right now. But nobody's had any kind of a big breakaway jam. So if Omaha can get a few of those in.
Exactly. But they are going to have to play some offense. I know
yes.
We keep saying it, but if they want to have one of those jams, they're going to have to.
That's what
to.
It's going
to
take. You can't just leave it to your jammer to get through on their own. You need to give her some help.
Yeah.
Get her a lane opened up and help her through it.
Like every jammer out there watching is nodding their heads and agreeing with you right now.
Some of them are probably jumping up and down the couch saying, yes, yet this, all of this.
All right.
Skateaway Faye and Pocahontas on the lines for Omaha and Paradise City, respectively. Skateaway Faye out in front right now. So that was her initial.
They're approaching the pack pretty quickly, hoping to pick up at least one, but jam is called. 0 points on that one for Omaha.
Three,
there we go. 3 points for Paradise City. So 132 Paradise City, 66 Omaha, 19 and a half minutes to go.
And Omaha again in green lining up in the front of the pack. Paradise City in back.
Mm-hmm.
Omaha 4-on-3 pack advantage. Bolt jammers trying to shift around. Nobody having a whole lot of luck just yet. Bang Bang trying to get around the outside, but it's Amelia Earhart up the inside for the lead jammer. So Omaha having some good things happen for him here. Bang Bang, though, also coming back into the mix, trying to get through.
There we go. Bang Bang is through on her initial.
So Amelia Earhart needs to get in here, get a point or two, call off the jam just like that.
Now, I'm not sure if she got all four there. She might have. There we go. 4 points. I saw her just kind of skip around there. She did land in bounds, and I thought I had heard that the whistles didn't go until after she landed, and I was right. There we go, 4 points.
Yeah, so Omaha this time holding Paradise City scoreless.
Mm-hmm. Still 62 points between the two teams, so still a lot of ground for Omaha to make up, but they seem to be figuring something out here. It's working for them.
They're definitely moving in the right direction.
Mm-hmm. With that said, though, Elsie Hammer through as lead jam for Paradise City. Rady Ruck really being worked over by the blocker there. I couldn't quite see the blocker's number, but
111, that is Rattlin' Bones.
Yeah, there we go.
Very effective blocker. She's able to jump sideways on the track.
Yeah, her lateral movement is really, really good. And her one-on-one blocking, clearly she's worked on that a bit.
4 points for Elsie Hammer. She calls off the jam, bringing Paradise City to 136. Omaha currently at 70. 17 and a half left to play in the game. Omaha with the right idea, trying to get their jammers through, get some points on the board. They're going to need to start making multiple passes, though, if they want to catch up.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, 17 minutes is still a substantial amount of time, but it's not all the time in the world. And yeah, when you're only scoring 2-3 points per jam, you're going to have to get in there and help so that you can get some of those higher netting jams in there. All right, so nice little tripod at the front there by Paradise City. Both jammers really struggling here. 32 Amelia Earhart only with 2 to beat now that number 24 Bama being sent to the penalty box. And Pocahontas still struggling at the back there with that long bridge of Omaha blockers.
Amelia Earhart did get through though.
There we go.
So Omaha at the front, doing a good job holding Pocahontas back as Amelia Earhart coming into the pack in scoring position.
There we go, and this is what Omaha needs right now.
Sidestepping around, Amelia Earhart clears three, last one passed. That is good for 5.
Nice work there by Amelia Earhart, 5 points. And yes, there we go, we've got a jammer penalty, a track cut penalty on Pocahontas. So this will now be a power jam for Omaha. So let's see if they get in there and help her out a little.
So far, no. They're just holding back, trying to, I think, get Paradise City to push forward and get a no pack call, so they have to let her go.
Yeah. Ooh. Big hit. Oh, my goodness.
And clockwise on that one, too. So big hit, big naughty hit.
Yeah, now, I'm not sure. It looked like Bammer hit her head there, but nobody has called over a medic. Yeah, I'm not sure. I know that the WFTDA protocol for head, for concussions is pretty strict. Mm-hmm. Usually you have to be assessed by a medic. You can't skate for another 20 minutes and then you have to be cleared by a medic before you can go back out.
Yeah.
With only 15 minutes left in the game at this point, if they were to assess her, she would not be skating any further.
Yes, and going, across sports here, when the NFL has been a huge part of just concussions and sports injuries how they relate to things.
It's so important, though. Mm-hmm. I mean, you need your brain for the rest of your life, and you can't mess around with that. If you take a hit, bonk your head, even if you think it's not a big hit, it doesn't matter. Get it checked out.
Yeah.
Put your pride aside.
And if you hit hard enough, get your helmet checked out too.
Absolutely.
They don't do impacts very well.
No.
Like they're well enough for this if you get the right kind of helmet for this.
Yeah.
Which they do have right over there at the skatehouse.net.
Yeah.
Or houseofskate.net.
Pretty glittery ones.
They do have some glittery ones over there.
So here we go. We've got, that is, sorry, we can't see her number just
Skate Away Faye?
Skate Away Faye.
Skate Away Faye. She's got some blue hair action going
there
on.
There we go. Yeah, the blue hair. And coming out of the penalty box is Pocahontas, still in her initial pass. Only 2 blockers there from Omaha, the other one coming out of the penalty box. Oh,
Skate Away Faye dropping low around the outside.
That was beautiful. Just a nice little bean dip. Yep.
Down and around, swoosh.
Yeah, oh, and look at this. Now we've got a forearm, Pocahontas from Paradise City heading to the penalty box. So this is now a power jam once more for Skate Away Faye. So far, Skate Away Faye putting up 10 points on this jam.
Omaha now holding back. Good thing to do now. The pack starts to break away. They need to jump up and get her a hole created.
There you go. So Skate
Away Faye called.
Already passing at least 2 set of hips. Now 3, so she's almost got all her points on this one. Being forced to the outside there by number 58, Sass and Bite. It was the end of that jam, so 4 more points there.
So 14-point jam.
That might be the biggest jam so far for
Omaha.
I'm
looking for it right now.
Mm-hmm. I don't think Omaha's put up any big double-digit ones like that just yet, so.
No, I don't see. Oh, there was a 14.
Oh, there we go. Okay. But that's just what they need.
It.
I mean,
yeah.
If you look at the score now, 92 for Omaha, 136. That is a point spread that is very, very attainable with 13 minutes left to go in this game. So hopefully that gave them a little bit of the boost that they needed. 89, Ellis Affliction, lead jammer for Paradise City.
He blasted a girl jamming for Omaha. A little held up in the back. She comes back in around. No pass, no penalty being assessed there. But lead has already been taken.
Yes,
so not that big an issue.
Girl through on her initial pass. So 5 points on the board for Paradise City. Paradise City jammer being passed now by a blaster girl. And yes, just as we suspected, calling off the jam.
No surprise there.
Any points.
Yeah, so the key for Omaha now is getting out first.
Yes, and I mean that's been the key for Paradise City the entire time. They've had lead the majority of the time, and it's definitely reflected in the score. So 141 right now, Paradise City. Omaha sitting at 92, 12 minutes left to go in the game.
Paradise City this time lining up in front. Omaha in back. Omaha 4-3 pack advantage.
And is that Rady Ruck?
That is Rady Ruck.
Yes, so Rady Ruck out for lead jam for Omaha. Bang Bang being recycled by, can't quite see the number there. But Rady Ruck already back in. Bang Bang takes off the helmet cover and is stood on her initial pass.
And Rady Ruck getting a cutting the track penalty.
Nice work there by the Paradise City blockers forcing that track cut penalty. The momentum was shifting a little bit, so I think this is good timing for that to happen for Paradise. And Bang Bang is not the jammer that I'd want to be blocking against on a power jam right now. So 5 points up on the board there for Bang Bang.
And already coming back around for our next run.
There we
Omaha.
Go.
Throwing themselves at her.
Yeah.
While throwing each other.
626, I believe. The hippie chick.
Bang Bang coming back and dodging around quite deftly. Little flare, she comes through. That is good for five more. But Rady Ruck back in the mix, trying to get through.
Yeah, and both jammers looking a little tired. Rady Ruck being recycled by number 58, Assassin Bite. Four more points on the board as Bang Bang gets through. Rady Ruck being forced to the infield. Once again, having to reset at the back of the pack.
Very nearly had a cut on the track penalty. Luckily, she was able to keep that out of bounds foot firmly planted on the ground.
Oh, and just as you're saying that, she stepped into the infield and then came back and in front of the Paradise City blocker. So another track cut penalty. So definitely not what they wanted. Again, the score is working in Paradise City's advantage again. You know, it was cutting down to almost a 30-point spread, but now back up to, you know, 68 points between the two teams. So
with 10 minutes remaining.
It might be a little bit of a stretch now, but
it's currently in Paradise City's hands.
Mm-hmm.
As long as they keep playing the way they are, they don't get careless, they don't get reckless, stay focused.
Yeah.
They can handle this and keep it wrapped up.
Yeah, so now, right now it's looking like Omaha has 37% of the points. So, of course, that leaves Paradise City with what? 63% of the points. So well above what they need. Clearly they are in control. And, yeah, 10 minutes, not a ton of time. I'd be getting a little worried if I was Omaha, but again, not impossible.
Yeah, there is still, you know, 10 minutes of gameplay left, so
anything could happen.
If Omaha can rally, start getting lead jammer out, getting multiple passes through, they still have a chance to bring this home.
They do, absolutely.
So a lot of things have to happen in order for that to work out that way.
The stars need to align.
In the meantime, Paradise City, they just need to stay in control.
Mm-hmm. And Omaha Jammers are going to have to work really hard to stay out of the penalty box here. All right, so LC Hammer through for lead. And approaching now the back of the pack, passing two sets of hips there.
We've got Rady Ruck standing in the box, ready to come out.
Oh, but very, very smart move by one of the Omaha blockers there. Dropping back on the inside, that was number 38, Crash Heartless, and she snuck back on the inside. Elsie didn't see her, she was on the outside, so track cut penalty, power jam now in favor of Omaha.
So Rady Ruck through her initial pass. Needs to pick up a little bit of speed here, try and get around. Again, this is where her blockers need to come in and try and open up some opportunities for her.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of just leaving her to contend.
But they're still not doing it. Wow. And that, I mean, it does work for some teams to play it that way, but I don't know, when you only have a limited amount of time and you're behind in points, maybe not the best strategy.
Yeah. And Rady Ruck with a cutting the track penalty now.
Yeah. Paradise City blockers really happy about that one. A little bit of cheering there on the track. I don't blame them. It's an exciting game. Mm-hmm. This basically guarantees their spot in the championship.
And with that belt on the line,
everybody
wants a piece of that belt.
Everyone does. I want a piece of that belt. No, I'm not.
I want to know why we don't have an announcer team belt.
We got fancy hats, though.
We do. Thanks to houseofskate.net for putting those together for us.
Yeah, they're amazing. I posted the photo on Instagram and sent them a big thank you because it's such a nice gesture.
Yeah, Kiki, Necro, Billy, and Rooster over there doing all their hard work for everybody. They're doing, you know, names and stickers and everything for anybody who comes over. Very knowledgeable, friendly team of people over there. More than happy to work with you.
Absolutely. All right, so 12 points in that jam for Paradise City. 4 on the board for Omaha. Omaha breaking the 100-point barrier there. So score not looking too bad. 101 Omaha, 177 Paradise City, but only 7.5 minutes for Omaha to really...
Yeah, starting to run out of time.
Yeah, it's catching up with them. They still have 2 timeouts. Still have their official review, so they might be able to get this working for them. But all right, Alice Affliction out for lead jam for Paradise City.
Amelia Earhart jamming for Omaha.
There we go. Initial pass is complete. Alice Affliction dodges to the outside, makes all the blockers move with her, and then takes the inside for 4 points. And calls off the jam before Amelia can put up any points. Oh, no, my mistake. 2 points.
Oh, she did sneak 2 in there.
No, I didn't see them. I am sorry for the misinformation.
She just flew right through there, picked up those 2 points.
Yeah.
We didn't even see it.
So 6.5 minutes left to go in this game.
And again, the winner of this game going on to our championship game coming up anywhere 6 to 6:30 start tonight. Depending on where we're actually at timeline-wise.
All right, I believe that's Skidaway Faye.
It is indeed.
Yeah, I recognize the blue hair.
See? We have our ways.
And Bang Bang working through the pack is super lead jam. Skidaway Faye stuck behind number 82.
Yeah, it's good.
Yes. 92.
Dangerously close to getting a leading with the head there. Is she using her head to try and push her way through?
Yep. That is not allowed.
Yeah, it's unlucky for her. There was no impact, so there wasn't a call. But
so 3 more points on the board for Paradise. 0 for Omaha. A little under 6 minutes left here.
81-point spread. Paradise City still definitely in control of this game.
Yeah, and I said it earlier in the other game I called for them. I'm very much expecting Paradise to make an appearance at D2 playoffs later this year. So very, very impressive both at Brouhaha and this weekend. So.
Yes, and the first of those Division II playoffs coming up in Wichita, Kansas, August 19th through 21st. Tickets are on sale right now at WTDA.com/tickets.
All right, so lead jam going to LC Hammer. And we've got the Omaha Jammer throwing her initial pass.
Rylan Gutisling with the star on.
Tiny little pack happening there. Got two blockers in the penalty box for each team currently, so just a little tiny micro pack. There we go. Now we've got four blockers out for Omaha. I believe they should only have three out there. Yeah, there we go. They picked up on that.
Okay.
So three blockers for Omaha, two blockers for Paradise. So definitely a pack advantage for Omaha on this one. And we've got Amelia, Earhart, and that
can't
is
quite does it.
Alice
Affliction.
Alice Affliction being forced to the infield, drawn back.
Yes, Alice Affliction with the blue pigtails.
Yes.
Couldn't quite see him from this angle.
And Alice Affliction cutting the track. She did not notice that two skaters ran back, came in front of both of them. So cutting the track definitely merited there. And Amelia Earhart puts up 4 points for Omaha. Let's see if her team goes in for offense here. Only two to beat, but again, two very, very strong blockers.
Yeah, Amazon, I get you. Very hard to get around. Now another one up at the front. Oh, she's able to sidestep around her and picks up five.
Yeah.
Alice Affliction re-entering play, running Alice right into all of the Omaha blockers.
So Alice Affliction does clear the pack. That is her initial pass. She had some nice offense there on the inside by Brat. That helped her get through.
So four more now for Amelia Earhart as she blasts her way past Brat, which not an easy one to do.
No, definitely not. Oh, and now Alice heading back to the penalty box. I missed the call on that one, unfortunately.
As did I,
it was
unfortunately,
a quick one.
Yeah.
Because it happened generally close to the penalty box. I didn't quite catch the signal. But so there we go, an extended penalty, power jam for Amelia Earhart.
We've
she
only
is
got
looking tired,
yeah,
though.
10 seconds, 8 seconds left now on the jam clock. So
she'll
get a couple more points here. That's going to be it.
There we go. So five more points. So nice jam there for Amelia. She puts
18.
Up, 18 points.
And Omaha going for an official review.
Hopefully someone will let us know what's going on. We like to keep everyone informed as to what the official reviews are for, but of course, tournament is a little bit short-staffed, so they haven't quite had an extra official to come over and let us know.
Yeah, we don't have any alt refs. We don't have any ref announcer liaisons.
Yeah.
So every once in a while we get lucky, and we've got one of the refs who will come over and let us know what's happening. If only someone knew Dictaphone and could make that happen. Mama.
So let's take a look at the numbers. So Paradise City sitting at 184, Omaha sitting at 122. So, I mean, when you look at the numbers in that sense, Omaha still falling a little bit short of where they need to be. They are sitting at currently 40% of the points. They need about 49 to maintain their current rank. So this might impact them a little bit in the rankings. But again, with all of the other games that they've had this weekend that have bumped them up, this may not have too big of an impact for them. I want to know what's going on.
Well, the referees are conferring over there in their corner.
Oh,
we gave
Rady
them a
Rock.
Little box to stand around.
Rady Rock is skating off. I believe she has fouled out of the game. Still want to know what the review is about, though.
Yeah. I'm just looking through here to see if I can get an idea of where she was at penalty-wise.
We don't have the whiteboard in the middle.
Unfortunately, no.
So usually that's our little cheat sheet for announcers, where we can just take a glance and see where everyone is at in terms of penalties. But
I count five for Radio Rock as a jammer.
As a jammer. And she's also been blocking, so it's very, very possible she got two other penalties as a blocker. And that's it. You can only get seven.
Make that six,
six
as
a jammer. There we go.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's it's unfortunate. She is a strong player for Omaha. Oh, look at this dictaphone coming over to let us know what's going on.
So they are challenging for a cut for Paradise City's jammer after coming back in from the box. The re-entry was legal, but they felt that she stepped out and came back in with a cut in the track penalty.
Yeah, so we'll know in just a second. I mean, the jammer is currently standing in the penalty box, so I'm not sure.
So
yeah, so
call on track stands.
Dick just let us know there. It stands as it is. That does mean Omaha loses their official review. Nice work there by the Omaha jammer.
Ryland Gottesling.
Yeah, but at the same time, Alice Affliction came out of the penalty box and is, you know, not even three, four strides behind her. So
and the pack is just racing around the oval.
Those poor outside pack refs. So
that's
all
right.
That for 1 point apiece.
Yeah, nobody thinks about the OPR.
Aw, poor little fellas.
So you don't think it's that much more distance to cross, but
it really is.
It's
though.
A huge amount of
and
space.
And once you actually skate it, I mean, yeah, it doesn't look like much when you're just looking at it on the screen there, but it's.
And the fun part too, when you're on the track, in between the lines, you can work that diamond. You can kind of cut those quarters
yeah,
a little bit, use
the
momentum.
On the outside.
No, you got to go all the way.
Yeah, and you have limited space too. I mean, you have 10 feet usually from where the crowd is sitting, and you know, about the same from where the actual player benches are. So you can't even, you know, cut it wide and then
mm-mm.
take
No, there's no way to, you know, kind of shorten anything off and use momentum to carry around. You have to step it through. And it's a lot of distance to cover.
Yeah. Yep.
Amelia Earhart back on the line jamming once again.
Yeah, and bang, bang for Paradise City.
Underway here. Omaha skating in green, trying to get up to the front of the pack as they try to hold Bang Bang back. They knock her down to the infield.
Bang Bang.
Ooh, Bang Bang get the forearm.
She's got to be sitting on a few penalties herself, so going to have to play it carefully. And again, Omaha just sitting back, waiting for the no pack, not helping their jammer.
See, lower level gameplay, you can get away with that because you're going to have people actually creating that no pack.
Not
part of the problem
level.
Here, they reform so quickly.
Yes. Yes. And, I mean, these are, based on rankings, Division III teams. Mm-hmm. But a lot of these teams are, you know, they're good enough teams to be playing at the D2 level. Paradise City is a perfect example. They're more than likely going to be at Division II playoffs. So you can't do that. You've got to get in and you've got to help your jammer.
Yeah, so they cannot do it by themselves, and especially with these walls that Paradise City is throwing up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
so hard to get around those.
Absolutely. Back when penalties were a minute long, sure, you know, let them push a little. Mm-hmm. That's fine. But you've got 30 seconds to score your points. That's it. Oh, and yeah, I thought that was a backlog. Definitely was. So number six from Omaha, demailing the coffin, heading to the penalty box.
And jam comes to a close. Mm-hmm. 9 points for Omaha and Amelia Earhart.
Yes, Earhart.
Hurt.
Looks like Omaha coach, they're trying to call a timeout. Yeah, okay, yes, they are going to allow it. There was 2 seconds left when... So there will be one more jam there.
This is going to take a fantastic jam from
it
Omaha
would.
To pull this out.
Absolutely, but it could be that they're just working towards their percentage
the
at
points,
this point,
yeah.
Right? I mean, if they can get in even 4 or 5 more points on this
right,
jam
it's
and hold
Paradise
to zero, it will help with their ranking, absolutely.
Yeah. And so this one, the odds of them pulling out 53 points and setting a new WTDA record. Unlikely.
But they're sitting at 42% of the points, which is definitely much better than they were doing just a few jams ago. Again, they need about 49% to maintain their current rank of 69. So, you know, both these teams are so close to being in Div 2 playoffs that the rankings are important when you're at that level.
And for what will be the last jam, we've got Paradise City lined up in front in the blue and white. Omaha in green just behind them as we take the action to the pivot line. Elsie Hammer jamming for Paradise City.
Knocked to the infield and set back up behind the wall of green. Wow, that is some tight packs. One Paradise City blocker being sent to the penalty box. Elsie Hammer, only two more, and she does get through. Lead jam, Paradise City.
And period clock has run out, so this game is in Elsie Hammer's hands.
Yeah,
she can call it any time.
And yeah, she's going in for more points. I don't know. I don't know that I'd risk it.
So now with another game coming up. For
no.
Her.
No, and I mean, you're going to win if you just call it, but maybe
yes,
not. There
try
we go,
and
her,
get those?
Her
yeah.
coach now yelling, call it off. There we go, Paradise City for the win. So really exciting game. Paradise City now has solidified their spot in the championship game. We'll find out really soon who they'll be up against. But
either be Oklahoma or Leeds.
Yeah, I think it would be really cool to have it be Leeds because then it's two international teams.
Yeah, our two furthest travelers coming in here. That would be cool to see.
Yeah, but if it's not, I mean, Paradise will for sure be in that game. They've been super exciting to watch all weekend and definitely earned their spot in that championship game. So we'll see how that works out when we get there. But for now, score official final, 132 for Omaha, 188 for Paradise City. Anything to add?
No, I think we've pretty much covered it all.
So
Paradise City taking their victory lap. One more to play here as they go on for the belt.
All right. Okay, well, we will leave you with that. We will see you later on. We'll both be calling the championship game in a little bit.
Yes,
here,
we will.
So we will catch you then. I am Mamacita.
I'm Rock the Mic.
And we will catch you at the